We help people get their videos watched. We have a couple services. One of them, you can upload a video to TubeMogul and easily super syndicate it to one or all of the video and social networking sites out there. So upload it to us, send it to YouTube and Vimeo and Dailymotion, the YouTube of France, all in one fell swoop. And then after we syndicate the video, we aggregate the analytics back into TubeMogul into a single dashboard so you can compare and contrast your viewership across venues. The biggest change is that when we started super syndication, if you got your video out there to all the places where people are watching video, your viewership was going to increase. That's not the case anymore. In fact, the content is growing much faster than viewership is. So every day it's harder and harder to get a video watched. We responded accordingly with a new product where if it's not enough just to get your video out there organically, we will help you by featuring it on kind of brand-friendly publisher sites in your target audience. And that's a cost per view product, so we only charge you, the advertiser, when someone clicks play on your video. The smartest advertisers, they've realized that the video as the ad is much more powerful than interrupting their target audience's favorite content. So you'll see really avant-garde advertisers producing and distributing their own content. The best ones don't do it in kind of a big campaign where they're hoping for, millions of views. They're doing it as part of a program where they'll release new videos and new content every day. And so their portfolio of views may be 1, 2 million views a month, but that's from hundreds of pieces of content. So I mean, that's what we're seeing the best advertisers are doing right now. It's all the above. I mean, some people are making their own webisodes. Some people are doing kind of branded shows. Some people are just repurposing 30-second TV spots. But what all of them are discovering is that there's actually an endemic audience out there, people that want to watch that content, and you don't need to interrupt other people's content to get to them. For a newbie, what they need to know is there are audiences out there on video sites and social networks that are consuming huge quantities of video, and that's growing 100% a year. So if you can get your content out into those venues, some people may discover your video. Now that's a starting point. That's not a guarantee for kind of huge masses of people watching your video, but that's where people can start, and then they can use us to get their content out there, and then to see who's watching it, where is it resonating, and how long are they watching it, what points in the content are they leaving, are they rewinding, are they fast-forwarding, what search terms are they using to find the video, where did they come from before the video, and based upon those things, they can iterate and try it again. YouTube's a dominant force, they're amazing. But there's gonna be a cap to the amount of people that watch your video on YouTube. Very few videos go viral. There's a lot of talk about viral videos. I think like 0.33% of all videos out there have over 1 million views. So you can't expect that to happen just by virtue of putting your video on YouTube. Whereas there are a new crop of more vertically oriented video sites and social networking sites where if your content has a vertical focus, if it's like a piece of automobile content, and you put that on streetfire.com, people went to streetfire.com solely to find automobile videos and to read the comments of other people that are huge auto fans, not to read the comments of the population writ large, which is what you get on YouTube. So YouTube's dominant, but it's no guarantee, and there's lots of other venues as well. I think the companies that have relied upon just throwing it out there, they've failed. It's too hard to just throw content out there and hope that people watch it. So increasingly, the videos that have millions of views, there's some type of paid media behind that as well to drive viewership to that video. What's next for us is we're figuring out how to use the data that we're collecting, and we collect a few billion live streams a month, or real-time streams a month. So our code is in the video players of a good number of the sites that we syndicate to. We will use that data kind of for our media product, where we feature videos in front of the target audience of our audiences of advertisers. So that's where we're going next. And it's exactly to solve this problem we've been talking about, where it's not enough just to put your video on video sites and social networking sites. So we have a product to use the data to get the video watched.